This tutorial will show you how to join the Seagate Business Storage Windows Server to a domain, create a new share for the domain on the Windows Server, and assign a domain user to the share. The first step is to set the static DNS server IP address for the domain. By default, the Windows Server NAS is set to obtain a DNS server IP address automatically. This setting needs to be changed and a static DNS server IP address entered manually. To complete this step, first, open the File Explorer and right-click on the network icon to launch the Network and Sharing Center. After the Network and Sharing Center page opens, click on the Ethernet link located in the View Your Active Networks section of the page. Once the Ethernet status pop-up box launches, click on the Properties button. When the Ethernet Properties box displays, select the Internet Protocol version 4 TCP/IPv4 entry from the list, then click on the Properties button. On the Properties pop-up box, click on the Use the following DNS server addresses radio button. Then enter the DNS server domain controller IP address for the domain you want to join in the preferred DNS server text field. When you have finished, click the OK button. The next step is to join the Windows Server NAS to the domain. To complete this step, first, right-click on the computer icon on the left side of the File Explorer page. Once the menu displays, click on the Properties menu item. The Systems page will open. In the Computer Name, Domain and Workgroup Settings section, click on the Change Settings link. After the System Properties pop-up box displays, click on the Change button. Then, click on the Domain Radio button to select Domain. Next, enter a fully qualified domain name in the space provided. Click on the OK button when you have finished. Next, enter a qualified domain administrator's username and password. Typically, a domain administrator would belong to a group of domain admins, enterprise admins, or an administrator group as determined by site or group policy. This information should be obtainable from the administrator of the domain you are joining. Click on the OK button after you have provided the required information. A Welcome to the Domain pop-up box will open. Click on the OK button to continue. Next, you will be prompted to restart your computer to apply the changes. Click OK, then select to restart now. These are all the steps required to join the Windows Server NAS to a domain. Next, we will show you how to create a share on the Windows Server and assign a user from the domain to that share. To begin, launch the Server Manager dashboard. After the dashboard opens, click on the File and Storage Services menu item. Then click on the Shares menu item. Next, click on the Tasks drop-down menu and select New Share from the list. There are 5 share profiles from which to select. For this tutorial, we will select the SMB Share Quick profile. After you have made your share profile selection, click on the Next button. Next, select a server and share location. For the share location, choose Select by Volume. Then select the volume where the share will be created. Note, it is recommended that you select a volume other than the C drive to locate the share. Click on the volume entry to select it. After selecting the share's location, click on the Next button. Next, you'll need to provide a name for the new share. Enter a name for the new share in the Share Name field. When you have finished, click Next. The next step is to configure your share's settings. Read through the options and select the configuration you want to use. When you have completed this step, click on the Next button. On the Specify Permission to Control Access page, you can indicate the permissions and assign a domain user to the new share. To continue, click on the Custom Permissions button. The Advanced Security Settings for the new share will open. Click on the Share tab to continue. By default, when a new share is created, the permissions for everyone are set for read-only. In this tutorial, we will modify the permissions so that only the domain user will have access to the share. To begin, select the Allow Everyone text entry. Then, click on the Remove button. Next, we will grant full access to the new share to the domain user. To continue, click on the Add button. The permission entry for our new share will open. Click on the Select a Principal link. Next, we will select a domain user. Type the name of a domain user in the Enter the Object Name to Select text entry box. Then, click on the Check Names button. The domain user will be verified and now listed as an object. After this step has been completed, click on OK. Next, we will set the permissions for the domain user. By default, permissions are set to read only. To modify the permissions, put a checkmark in the Full Control checkbox. Then click on the OK button. After the permissions for the user have been set, click on the Apply button to save your changes. Then click on OK. Once the Specify Permissions to Control Access page displays, click on the Next button. The Confirm Selections page will display. Read through and confirm the settings for the new share. When you are finished, click on the Create button. You will be advised that the new share was created successfully. Click on the Close button to complete the operation. These are all the steps required to join the Business Storage Windows Server NAS to a domain, create a new share, and assign a domain user to that share. For more information about the product and its features, please view the rest of the Seagate Business Storage Windows Server NAS tutorials.